بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to the short daily reminder. Inshallah, today we will learn the beautiful teachings of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam regarding sleeping. But before we do, make dua for all those people who helped in making these short daily reminders. And second thing, subscribe to our channel, turn on the notifications button, and if you benefit and you like this short daily reminder, press the like button below and share it with others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in regards with sleep, وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا, that we have made your sleep a source of rest. We human beings need to sleep. It does not make a difference how big or small you are, or how strong or weak you are. You need to sleep as a human being. But if we sleep according to the beautiful teachings of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then each and every single moment spent in sleeping, we will be rewarded for it. So, two birds, one stone. We get the benefit of gaining reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for sleeping, and also we get to give our bodies rest. The beautiful teachings of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam regarding sleeping are split up into three different sections. The first section is preparing oneself to go to sleep. Second section is laying down, trying to sleep. And third and final section is when waking up from one's sleep. So today, inshallah, we will start with learning the beautiful teachings of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam regarding preparing to go to sleep. The first sunnah is we should not eat and go to sleep straight after. It is a sunnah of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to take a short walk after eating or reading few nawafil salah before laying down to go to sleep. The second sunnah is to use the washroom and relieve oneself from the need of going to toilet. The third sunnah is to use the miswak. It is very important that we clean our teeth before going to sleep. So after we have finished using toothbrush or toothpaste, we should use the miswak, as this will help in digesting the food. Similarly, it gets rid of foul smell and the yellow marks on our teeth. The fourth sunnah is to make wudu, ablution, before going to sleep. Our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned that whoever does wudu before they go to sleep, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appoints angels who make dua for him throughout the whole night. Whenever this person, he turns in his sleep, the angels make this dua that, O Allah, forgive his or her sins. Similarly, this person, if he dies in his sleep, he will be classified a martyr, and on the day of Qiyamah, he will be raised amongst the martyrs. The martyrs, they will get one of the highest positions in the heaven. The third benefit mentioned by our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam for the one who goes to sleep after doing wudu is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect this person from shaitan disturbing him and troubling him. The fourth benefit, our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned regarding that person who does wudu before going to sleep is that this person has true dreams and Allah protects him from nightmares. The fifth sunnah of going to sleep is that we should put on our nightwear. Yes, it is the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam to have separate clothes just for sleeping. The sixth sunnah is that we should apply collyrium, also known as surma or kuhl. Three strikes in the right eye and then three strikes in the left eye. The seventh sunnah is to comb one's hair before going to sleep, as this is means of comfort for a person when he is trying to sleep. Insha'Allah, we will discuss more sunan of sleeping in the next part. I hope you enjoyed and benefited from this short daily reminder. Make sure you subscribe to our channel, turn on the notifications button, press the like button and share it with others. Till next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.